Linda Vonner must know that tulips are my favorite flowers because that's what we're talking about today. Linda Vonner's garden, look at it. It's unbelievable. The tulips there are exquisite, along with all kinds of spring blooms popping from window boxes, planters. That is just breathtaking. Now, if you love this kind of kaleidoscope of color, now is the time to plan for next year because years of work go into this.
Well, it's not even necessarily years of work, but it's a whole year of work. And the planning starts now, believe it or not, because you and I were talking, you don't plant the bulbs until fall. But if I want to decide, like if you drove by my house right now, as many people do, and they'll say, oh my gosh, what colors are those? What blends are those? Where do you get them? Well, what I do is I decide what I want to have next spring, and I put them on reserve now at my favorite wholesaler, and that's colorblends.com. And the reason I do that is because they sell out of their favorite blends, and I want to make sure I get mine and put them on hold so that when it's time for me to plant them in the fall, they will be there.
We're looking at that video right now. That is Linda Vonner's front yard. Can you
believe
that?
As we speak, right now, it looks just like that.
I mean, that's like a tourist attraction.
It almost is. I can sit in my office and count the number of cars that go by in an hour, and it's pretty amazing.
Wow. Yeah. Okay, we want to ask you some of your most frequently asked questions that you get about your tulips. The first is, how many do you plant?
Okay, that display that you just saw on camera was about 800. So I plant 800 to 900 every year, and I do replant each fall. So overall, I plant thousands of bulbs in general, but in the front, just the tulips alone, there's probably about 800.
What do you do with the old bulbs if you replant each fall?
Okay, so despite what a lot of people think, tulips really don't reliably come back. So I treat them as an annual, and I just pull them out when they're finished. I don't try to leave the foliage in place to brown so it will be saved for next year like you do with daffodils. Daffodils will reliably perennialize. But tulips are kind of one-shot wonders. So if I want that kind of display every year, I just pull them out, I compost them, and things that are already there in the garden will mature and fill in place, or I might add a few annuals. But basically, I just pull them, compost them, and I replant in the fall.
I have to ask you this. 800 to 900 bulbs that you plant each year in the fall, do you have any help?
Most years I have done it myself. Lately, I'm so busy that I often get help. But that's a good point, because none of this one at a time, Heather, you know, with a little bulb, little bulb tool, none of that one at a time. You dig big holes and you put maybe 25, 50, 100 in each hole. So it makes pretty quick work.
Okay.
Because you're not doing it individually.
Yeah.
Very, very quickly and not necessarily even expensively, because you can get 100 flower bulbs wholesale for like $35.
Wow, that's incredible. It really is.
Yeah, and people always ask me, well, can anybody do that? And I say, yeah, just go to colorblends.com. It's where I get mine, and yeah, you can buy 100 tulip bulbs. You know, the more you buy, the better the price break.
Okay, and now one problem you see with tulips, when the wind blows, basically, they go away.
Right.
They last maybe a week to 3 weeks. For me, how do you keep them lasting
longer? So here's how you kind of mitigate that problem, or a couple of different ways. Number one, when you buy them, I buy blends, and the blends, like from Color Blends, they mix all different kinds of bulbs that will bloom early, mid and late season in the spring.
Okay.
So let's say in early spring we have a really hot, windy day, and those that are in bloom, basically the blooms are blown away. But I know that there's more coming. So a little bit later there'll be more mid-range, mid-timed blooms that will come, and then late season blooms as well. Another thing you can kind of do is if you're in a really exposed area, plant bulbs that are a little bit shorter, because if they're shorter, the wind resistance isn't going to be as great.
Yeah, anything that's low to the ground.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay, finally, is it expensive?
No, it really isn't expensive. And in fact, in this catalog, they give some comparison. So you can get 100 bulbs for less than it would cost you to spend, you know, dinner for two or a night at a hotel. So if you can get 100 bulbs for $35 and they last for 2 to 3 weeks, that's a pretty good return on your investment.
It sure is. And make sure you get some help. That would be a good date in itself.
Yeah.
And you can see Linda's tulips just by driving by her house if you have her address. And if you don't, you can go to her Instagram if you'd like more gardening inspiration. Linda always has great posts there. You can also check out her website, lindavonner.com. Thanks, Linda.
Sure.